bit of a tour of the golden ears via Google Earth. Show you the route that Jason and I are going to take on our way to summit golden ears. And it's right here. We're going to take this ridge line all the way across here, all the way up here. This is a bit of a tricky part here. We gotta kind of cross there over to the emergency shelter. Once we get to the emergency shelter right there, then it's just straight up. And pretty simple, all the way up to the top. So that's the plan. Let's see if we can actually accomplish it.
Slippery stuff.
So word of the wise, make sure your broth is cooked before you take a bite.
In our quest to climb golden ears, we had to stay along the path, and we were cursed with this campsite.
Hear the sarcasm in his voice. This was a fantastic campsite.
So Saturday morning, we got back up to the trail just a little ways before where we stopped the last time. And this is the lookout, and it looks a heck of a lot less snowy and a lot more doable.
So we have now made it past the point where we went last time, and
no snow. Wonderful.
New unexplored terrain.
Well, we're at 3,100 feet, and this is our first sign of snow. So that's about 2,000 feet higher than 2 months ago. So we're a lot closer and a lot higher. That's where we want to be. Okay, so we're at the top of the ridge here, being swarmed by flies, but we now have a 360 view. We just made it up a sketchy part. I had to use our ice axes. That was pretty steep. That's where Jason is. That's where it's leveled off. It's quite steeper than that. And thankfully, we've made it to a place where there's a breeze. Take care of the flies for us a little bit, and a shelter where we might just take a breather. The flies don't follow us in.
Okay, we had a little lunch stop in the winter shelter there, and we're only about 45 minutes away from the top.
Here's Mike doing something stupid. That's how far he's gotten up. Started down there.
Heart,
Well, Mike, here we are on the top of Golden Ears. We made it. We actually made it to the top this time.
Made it without my backpack. I did something very silly. Well, I got to a spot that I got myself in trouble, and I didn't want to risk going up anymore, and so I had to turn around. So I had to carefully take it off and lower it down to a ledge using this. Got it down to the ledge, and it just barely fell.
And how far did it fall?
I have no idea where it is. It's likely gone.
100, 200 feet, 300 feet. And what was in that backpack, Mike?
An iPhone, a GPS, the snowshoe rentals, $400 jacket.
And the kicker.
A bunch of gear.
Car keys.
Oh, our car keys. I got it. Yeah.
Dun, 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 dun. Yeah, I feel like playing epic music right now. Because Mike got his backpack. He actually got it.
And that's how she's done.
That's right.
Oh.
Hey, I feel like epic music should be playing right now.
Epic music is playing right now. Well, I'm feeling a lot better now that I recovered my bag.
What do I see there, Mike?
Yeah.
Are those straps?
Yeah. Cannot even begin to explain what an unlikely rescue that was. The bag fell between the cliff and where the snow meets. Yeah. There's a crevasse. It fell down the crevasse, down, and it happened to hit a ledge down there. And we were able to jimmy-rig a long enough rope to hook onto the end of this. And
about 10 feet.
We were on the edge of that crevasse doing this, like, I don't know, 15 minutes until I finally got something that I thought, oh, let's give it a shot. I caught on something with this tip. I kid you not, it was caught on that little tip. That's how much was grabbing onto the bag as I pulled it up. So amazing rescue. Oh, it wouldn't be an adventure if there wasn't a misadventure.
Yeah.